Oh, you got a shield now. I didn't even see that.
Yeah, I got a shield, and I've been getting little upgrades here and there. I'm just more pissed because I didn't figure out this whole satellite thing until recently, and I've already been to all these rooms, but I didn't know I had to, like, do something. Alright. How do I get up there? Oh, no, there's another one.
Shepherds reactivate.
Yeah. So, in any case, oh shit. I think, quite happily, I don't believe the show really has like a theme that it's going for. It's just it's just your standard coming of age story, you know.
I wouldn't even call it a coming of age story because a lot of the prominent characters are middle-aged.
Sure.
Winona Ryder isn't coming of age.
Well, you know, you got your kids' adventure. You have the whole older daughter, Hoobinimbub with discovering her womanhood and whatnot.
The theme is, we're like an 80s movie. That's the theme.
That is.
That's fine.
That is. Wait, did I come from there? Did I do that one? I did that one. Why is it still there? Gosh darn it. We're like an 80s movie. You remember 80s movies. Oh,
shit. Was the laser rapid fire the whole time and I just didn't know?
I mean, I'm hitting the
yeah.
The thing pass, but... Yeah, you can just hit it as much as you want.
Alright, I'm just a dumbass then.
Oh no, or I'm out of laser now or something? I don't know.
Oh, so there isn't it? Okay, okay.
There's like a recharge for it, a battery recharge.
Chris Stuckman can do what he wants, and it's fine.
Who's that?
One of the pricks from the Ghostbusters review. Not the half in the bag, but the classic Ghostbusters review. I called these YouTubers pricks, and I was joking about it.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And in editing, they put pictures up, just other, you know, some three YouTubers.
Right.
And one of them was Chris Stuckman.
Okay.
Apparently he unsubbed from RLM.
Oh, so he was a little mad?
I think I've heard it wasn't recent, though. So he's been, it might not have been because of that. More bullshit. It's just more bullshit. I'm done with bullshit.
Rich isn't feeling the bullshit tonight, people. Rich is not feeling the bullshit.
Ask Jack what the controls for this game are like. Jack, what are the controls for this game like?
Sloppy.
Sloppy?
I feel loose. Like, even moving my character, it's
okay.
Because it there's that little, like, turn animation.
Mm-hmm.
Everything feels loose.
Okay.
Everything feels, like, aiming is a bit of a hassle. Flying around is fun. Like, just being ahead, that's kind of neat.
Oh, flying is great, actually, yeah.
But
I wish the whole game were just floating around as the head.
Yeah. But, like, being a person, it's a little loose and gummy. Not gummy, it's just loose. It does not feel good. Right. Yeah, see, that makes me think I fucked something up. Did I, Rich? I might have.
Jack, do you carry your 3DS around, or is it mostly at home?
Mostly at home. Sometimes I'll bring it, you know, here, if I think I'm going to stream, I thought I did this one already. What? You know, or if I'm going on a trip, or if I know I'm going somewhere where I'll have, like, 20 minutes of downtime, I'll bring my 3DS.
Mm-hmm.
And, Actually, now I'll probably bring my my Vita because I have a new game for it that I want to play.
Well, with that, would you consider it a good handheld then?
What?
The 3DS.
Oh, yeah, well, it depends on what game I'm playing.
Okay.
Like when I was playing SteamWorld Heists on the 3DS, yeah, I'd bring that with me.
But I mean, in general, if you can't just shove it in your pocket and bring it whenever, wherever, it's just always on you, does that in some ways make it a bad handheld?
Absolutely. The 3DS is too big just to bring with me.
So now they're going to make a bigger one.
But by the way,
solution.
That's the same with the Vita, though. The Vita is also too big and too unwieldy just to bring with me. I need to pre-plan shit. You know, the only gaming system I have on me at all times is my phone. So.
I wonder if we're seeing the beginning of the end with this NX.
Nintendo is, I hear, doing pretty well with this whole Pokemon Go thing.
How much is the developer getting? Like, and it's a free-to-play game, right?
Yeah, but they're still they are earning $6 million a day.
What percentage does the, just out of curiosity?
I think the developer gets the bulk of it, and Nintendo gets a very little bit of it, because all they did was give them the character licenses.
Yeah.
Did you hear the funny thing about Nintendo stock?
What?
The day after Pokemon Go came out, it was a huge success. Their stock went through the roof.
Yeah.
And then 2 days later, when all the investors realized Nintendo didn't make the game, their stock plummeted. They all sold.
Really?
Like, it's still like above where it was initially, but like it spiked up and then came right back down once investors realized that they didn't make the game.
Oh, damn.
I think it's great.
Damn.
That's great. But hey, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? Nothing. So that's the real question is, let's say you're a person who rides the bus all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Right, rides public transportation all the time. You want to bring something with you to play on the bus.
Yeah. You're playing your phone game.
You're playing your phone game. Maybe you have a 3DS, which is still giant. Maybe you have a Vita. Are you comfortable bringing a laptop computer on the bus?
No.
Because I think that's how big the NX is going to be. It's going to be as big as this screen.
Yeah,
right
I'm
here.
Saying it's going to be a failure as a handheld.
Absolutely.
The question is, are they going to discontinue the 3DS for it? Like, what?
And it's like the 3DS, if I had to choose a handheld to bring with me everywhere, it would be the 3DS. You know why? It folds.
I don't understand Nintendo. A lot of the things they do just makes me say, what the fuck are you thinking? And yet, they still have a fuckload of money.
Well, yeah.
It's the weirdest thing. Is it all? It's all been handheld, though. Their money surpluses, right? And it's all been thanks to Pokemon and handhelds.
Oh, yeah. That's where most of their money comes from.
So could this be the end of that?
No, they'll always make Pokemon. Well, maybe not always. I don't know.
They're going to release a flop handheld in a world where cell phones are taking over handheld gaming. And it's just going to be... That will end. So is Nintendo actually worth more than Sony at this point?
Sony has done bad enough. That's a good question. No, Sony's doing pretty good. I mean, in the video game field, they've been failing everywhere else.
Well, I've heard that everything else has been failing so hard that Nintendo as a company is their stock value. I don't know if the stock, maybe it's just the stock value or just in general, they're supposedly much better off than Sony is in general.
Oh, I'd absolutely believe that. I would absolutely believe that.
How many years until Nintendo releases for PC? When they're on their death throes.
Yeah. Look at this.
Yeah.
I get this upgraded, so now I can headbutt another robot and put my head on him. That's funny.
Okay. It'll be when... when Nintendo starts going down the road, Sega has gone down.
The Wii U has been a pretty big flop.
Yeah.
For Nintendo.
Yeah.
Their handheld has given them a nice cushy crutch, so they've been fine. Here's what I'm going to say.
Mm-hmm.
If they have another console flop, that's when they'll start porting to PC.
How much money do they have in the bank though?
I think they can probably absorb another console flop. But then what?
Try again. They don't seem to learn very well. I'm not kidding.
I think you give them one more console flop, and then just to get a little more extra money in the bank, they'll start putting out stuff on PC.
I'm going to say three more console flops.
Three more?
Three more console flops and about 15 years.
Wow. That's a... That's a lot. Oh, that's right.
They won't go away until the handheld has gimmicks that don't work. Which is right about now, in my estimation. Nintendo has, for the last 20 years? 15 years? Had... consoles that ultimately didn't do that well. I know the Wii was doing really good at first, but it lost in the end, right?
The
Wii?
Over,
yeah.
No, I mean, we did incredible numbers. Everyone owned a Wii. Even people who didn't care about games owned a Wii. We did incredible.
They bought it. They used the Wii Sports. Did they ever buy any other games?
Probably not.
Yeah.
But remember, Nintendo, unlike other game men,
makes profit on the console.
Exactly. Yeah. You know what I was going. You know where I was going with that.
Yeah.
Come here, I want your body. Mine.
But like the GameCube underperformed.
GameCube underperformed. Still a fine system.
How did the N64 fare? Because that came out. Well, it did good at first, but then. Then the PlayStation, like, kill it immediately? Or, like, hurt it immediately very badly? They quickly supplanted Nintendo.
Something more orange.
Because I don't know if the N64 was anywhere near as successful as the NES or the Super Nintendo.
I think the N64 was pretty successful. Someone look up the numbers.
All right.
I think N64 did fine.
I mean, I'm biased because I think every game on it was an ugly piece of fucking shit.
Uh-huh. Oh, hello. Orange access accepted. No, I have
Cause I'm trying to think which Nintendo consoles were flops. The GameCube was kind of a flop.
GameCube was kind of a flop.
Then the Wii was next.
I think the GameCube was a mild flop.
Okay.
Wii, giant, huge success.
Yeah.
Wii U, huge flop.
Okay, because by merging the console with a handheld, are they fixing their troubled console market, or are they going to drag down their handhelds with the NX? That's the question.
Right.
That's the question.
Whoa. Apparently he's up there. Okay. Right? And the real question is, are they going to... Shit. Are they going to discontinue handheld for the NX?
Well, what's the dumbest thing they could do?
Yes.
Then yes, they will.
You think?
They do some things that baffle you.
They do. They do some things that baffle me.
Just
Headbutt is OP.
The Wii is like the avatar of video game consoles.
Oh, everyone wants to go see it and know it. Yeah, that is, by the way, that's incredibly accurate. Everybody went to go see it. Who said that?
I'm going to scroll up.
That was perfect.
Perfect analogy. That was Darmok.
Darmok, perfect analogy.
Ironic that somebody called Darmok would say something so easily understandable and relatable.
Right?
Darmok. And a lot of people in the chat have no idea what the fuck I'm talking about.
You mean the best TNG episode ever? Darmok and Jalad and Tanagra?
That species deserves to die out. They deserve it.
They're fine.
Fucking idiotic language. It's amazing they figured out how to rub two sticks together.
No, it's, by the way, like it's one of those alien races that once you start applying any sort of logic to it, completely breaks apart, but it's a fun episode. Really fun episode.
Wii U, when the sails fell. German souffle. I love reference. I Banesist 00. Let's put it this way. I had a Wii U for 2 months and then sold it. And my story is common. I'll keep it around for the No More Heroes games. Mm-hmm. Actually, no, I can use those in the Wii U.
Yeah, you just need a controller. You know, make sure to keep a couple of your Wiimotes.
Yeah.
As soon as I got the Wii U, I got rid of. But I mean,
And the Galaxy games.
I had my Wii up until we got the Wii U. Like, we just, you know, we'd have it around.
Yeah.
Didn't play it much.
Yes, Nintendo's problem has always been third-party games. Total misanthropy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, what have I got here?
Yeah.
Riddle of Steel says, sorry, Rich. I think I tune in too much to the... I'm terrible with words. Acerbic? Dickish comedy of best of the worst. Acerbic, right? I've seen that word. I've read that word a bunch of times, but I've never heard it pronounced, I don't think.
Then you've heard it or seen it pronounced more than I have, because I have no idea what you're talking about.
You can't see something pronounced.
Whoa.
Then forget you're a real person with a fiancé and Ghostbuster shirts and stroller computer children. That's right.
Our stroller child will be reborn!
Atomic Mousetrap says, nonsense, Rich. Every decision Nintendo makes is a good one, such as the Virtual Boy.
Classic. Classic Virtual Boy.
Beyond Infinite says, a right-handed fellow named Rich, in writing right, always wrote right, W-R-I-T-E, and then the second time, just R-I-T-E, where he meant to write right. If he'd written right, okay, now I get it. I stopped to explain that one, and now I get the whole thing. There's more of the same. Right, Rich would not have wrought not writing right. I love you guys. Let me do it now. Now that I know it was a bit, and I'm going to do it all uninterrupted.
Okay.
A right-handed fellow named Rich, in writing right, always wrote right where he meant to write right. If he'd written right, Rich would not have wrought not writing right. I love you guys. Synonyms. They're not synonyms. What's sound alike? That's synonym, right? No, wait.
What?
Spelled differently, sound alike.
No,
that's synonyms, same meaning.
Yeah.
Yeah, what is the word I'm looking for?
It's
got a name.
Yeah.
And I can't think of what it is because I'm a dumbass. Onomatopoeia? No, that's like boom. Boom!
Oh, that's right. You're right.
Onomatopoeia.
Homonyms.
Thank you, Chad. homonyms.
Onomatopoeia?
Homonym.
That's it. The power dome is down that old.
I'm so happy you were able to get through that without fucking up, Rich. Just this guy you know says, PS2, 155 million.
Oh.
Nintendo DS, 154 million.
That's pretty good.
Game Boy Color, 118 million.
Nice.
PlayStation, PSX, 102 million. The Wii, 101 million. Xbox, the Xbox 360 specifically, 84 million.
Okay. So wait, was N64 in there?
Not yet.
Okay.
These are ranked, like, highest to lowest, too.
Oh, so what was the highest?
PS2, which
right,
makes perfect sense to me. 155 million.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know these were ranks.
These are ranks.
Go through them again.
Number one, the PS2, 155 million.
Yeah.
Number two, the Nintendo DS, 154 million.
Okay.
Number three, the Game Boy Color, 118 million. Number four, PSX, 102 million.
102 PSX.
The Wii is fifth. It's under, you know, a lot of handhelds that Nintendo came out with.
Yeah.
The two PlayStations at 101 million.
Okay.
Then the Xbox 360 at number six with 84 million. It's a pretty big drop off. I'm kind of surprised. I thought there would be more 360s.
Well, you know what? As we get older in the years, PCs started playing a part in this.
Consoles are dying out.
Yeah.
Yes, they are.
Yeah, of course they are. Everyone knows that.
I don't care because I'm a PC guy.
Right.
But seeing it in writing here is kind of interesting. They have six here twice, probably because they're so close, but one number is clearly higher than the other. Could just be a misprint. PS3 at 83 million, which I like the PS3 more than the Xbox, because the Xbox 360 was a poorly engineered piece of crap that would break down constantly.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm shocked that it's that close.
Mm-hmm.
PSP at number seven with 82 million.
PSP.
What?
Wait,
no.
It took me the PSP sold more than the Nintendo 64?
That is... Now we need to double check all of these.
Yeah.
Number eight, Game Boy Advance, 81 million. See, I can't believe that. Game Boy Advance under the PSP?
I equally can't.
Unless this is just how many were produced and not sold. Like, it's a whole warehouse out there full of PSPs. It's the only way that makes sense to me. Number nine, the NES, it's 61 million. Number 10, 3DS. 59 million. So you got a big drop off there with the handhelds, don't you? The DS, 154 million. The 3DS, 59. It's a difference of like 100 million, Jack.
I think people still have their DSs. I think they made the DS too.
Are they still making games for them?
I don't know. Maybe. I don't know.
And if they're not, then it doesn't matter if they're still using the DS. They're not buying the new shit Nintendo's making.
Right.
Which is a company is going to hurt them. Then SNES, 49 million, PS4, 40 million, N64, 32 million, what? Wii U, 13 million.
Wow.
I don't see Xbox One even listed on here.
Because it sold 12.
It did.
12, just 12 units.
What did the Xbox One sell, chat? I'm very curious to hear that now. PS4, 40 million. I mean, that's a lot lower than PS3, but what is it, about like two-thirds through its life? Like, we're already talking about new ones already.
They are. They're bringing new ones out, yeah.
Oh, God.
They're bringing new ones out. The Xbox One S.
Darmok's killing it tonight.
Yeah.
Darmok says 12 units. 12 individual units on the Xbox One.
That's what I said.
You said, oh.
That was my joke.
I thought you meant 12 million. Because the Wii U was 13 million. I didn't know you meant it that way.
That would, no, then it's my fault. But I ain't detected any green shepherds round bounds. Give me a minute
to figure something out. Gender not recognized. Consoles are dying.
Citizens got a gender ID. Consoles might be dead already, Rich.
I can't even say they're being replaced with the PC. They're being replaced with cell phones. Everything's going to be an annoying fucking touch game from here on out. Welcome to the dark dystopian future of gaming, everybody.
Everyone's having a great time.
And Jack, I'm sorry for not catching on to what you were pitching. I'm sorry. I whiffed, is what happened.
No, I didn't. I did a bad job of telling the joke, you know.
That's yeah.
What do you mean, gender not present? Oh, I get it.
Okay, where are we at? The off switch says, I've paid for Ocarina of Time 4 times now. As long as they have ways to push their classic games, then they will likely never go bust. Until those nostalgia junkie 80 kids die, at least. Hey, we're getting older. Matter of time. Inappropriate gender. Obviously, we won't live to see it. Because, you know, by the very nature of that, we'll be dead.
Right.
80s kid can't live off to see the 80s kids die off.
Oh.
Yeah.
Rich, you just got really dark. What am I supposed to do here?
Fisted by Dope Smoke says, my dad loves the Wii U because he can play football on the toilet. PC Master Race, I just packed a bowl from cleaning out my keyboard tray. LOL.
Wow.
Fuck my cock. Congratulations.
I mean, first of all, you're a really messy weed user. Yeah. or like, was packing a bowl your reward for cleaning out your keyboard tray? Or in packing previous, there's two options here. It's just dusty, and he dusted it, and he did a little work, and as a treat, now I'm going to have some marijuana smoke. Or
maybe his keyboard was filled with, like, some kind of, like, dust or residue from laxatives, and the bowl he filled was his toilet.
There are three options, then. There are three options. You guys.
You know, going back to 80s kids dying.
Yeah.
Doesn't Stranger Things make you feel old?
Isn't
it really good at making you feel old?
No, I don't know.
Look at when they use, like, those giant kind of wall-mounted phones.
Yeah.
Everything. And Winona Ryder alone. Do you remember Beetlejuice?
I do.
When she was barely an adult. She was playing a teenage kid.
Right.
And now here she is playing a middle-aged mom of a teenager.
I guess I don't see the problem with it. People get older.
It's not a problem. It just makes me feel it. It makes me feel my age.
There's a puzzle here, Rich. There's a puzzle here, and I don't necessarily know what to do about it.
Did you try every different type of body? Every different type of...
Yeah, so, like, this is a gender bathroom, right? Or this is a girl bathroom, right? And so all these are girl bodies. But here, like, this one has a skirt, right?
Yeah.
I go here. Gender not recognized. But then you can make a head pop out of this head thing.
Yeah.
But I can just pick it up, you know, like.
Just like, go over there with the head and see what happens.
Is this a guy's body? Gender ambiguous.
Try just bringing the head. What happens?
Right. All right. Come here.
Because it gives you a head. Female gender
confirmed. Oh, I thought it did that.
Oh,
oh.
My.
Oh, all right.
Someone said you took the male head. If you tried that earlier, you probably used the male head.
Oh, whoopsie. All right. Whoopsie doopsie.
Hump J Bear says, would you guys ever do a Stranger Things spoiler stream? Yes.
Yes.
Jack has not seen it yet.
We probably... We most likely, we will. First, like, that's just it. We're going to do a Stranger Pass spoiler, Stranger Things spoiler stream. I just need to finish watching it.
Yeah.
Hold on to your britches.
And, you know, it's only been out, what, a couple weeks? So probably by next week, Wednesday, I will have seen it all.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, how many episodes are there? Eight? Nine?
Eight.
Okay.
Eight.
So by this time next week, I will have seen them all. So next week, Wednesday, we'll give you guys a full week to watch all of Stranger Things. Whoa. Cool.
Any thoughts on Kung Fury or Turbo Kid? I like Turbo Kid. Haven't seen Kung Fury. I know Jay's seen both. He wasn't that fond of Kung Fury, but he loves the shit out of Turbo Kid.
Turbo Kid's great.
Yeah, Turbo Kid is amazing.
Turbo Kid is amazing. I've seen Kung Fury, and...
What's the complaint? Because I haven't seen it.
It lacks any sort of subtlety. And that's kind of its shtick. Like, for example, you know, so it stars a cop who's so good at Kung Fu that's his superpowers.
Mm-hmm.
It's all shot on green screen, so it's a very flat action. And then it's just, like, hyper... It's so, like, hyper crazy that it's got to be funny, right? Like, the bad guy punks put a skateboard under a cop car and then, like, kick the skateboard and the cop car, like, goes into the air and does a bunch of flips and then they shoot it with, like, 80 million machine guns and it blows up.
Okay.
It's just over the top. It's so over the top that the joke wears thin really fast. It's not, like, homaging to anything crazy. It's just crazy.
Okay. So. And I can't speak. I haven't seen it, so. But I do know, anyone in the chat, if you haven't seen Turbo Kid, Turbo Kid is great.
Turbo Kid's great.
Lord Belmont says, the 1980s seem like the new 1950s for nostalgia. You're not old, Rich. You're only in your 30s. That's cringy when young people say they are old, especially teenagers. I'm in my fucking late 30s. I'm getting there. I'm getting there.
Ah, what's old?
You're only as old as you feel, and I feel very old. So I'm about 80.
There you go.
I'd say, no, mentally, I'm like, I'm 67. Mentally.
Mentally, you're 67?
Yeah.
Oh. I like it. Oh, not fast enough. I get it. I just got a new boost power.
That's an oddly specific mental age. That's why I chose it. Like 5 or 0, it's a bit too on the nose. It's a bit too. But when you say 67, I think it's funnier. Because it's specific.
Because
it adds truth to it.
Because it makes it think that you've been thinking
about
it.
Yeah.
It makes it seem like you've been thinking about it. Oh. Wow.
If we're lucky, this gravelith will just take us right by the power dome and straight to the archives. The archives got a detailed record of Methuselah's activity. I'm hoping we can find out exactly what y'all doing here. Not that I don't like your company. Hell's bells. The way down is blocked by them three big shaft doors. Y'all gonna have to cut the power to each one.
Turtle the Wise says,
yeah.
Real question.
Real question.
Yep.
Real question.
Oh.
Yeah. Possibly. A buddy had his wife abscond with their kid, moved to another state, is filing for separation, and won't talk to him. Should I inform him that that is technically kidnapping or shut up?
That sucks. You know what? It kind of depends on what he wants to do with it, you know? If he wants to get his shit back, yeah, then inform him.
Yes, that sounds like a messy situation.
Yeah.
You can tell him that's technically kidnapping, but is it? I don't know. At what point is it kidnapping?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's you need parental consent.
Well, they're both parents, though.
Yeah, but one, you know,
he should be able to see his kid. Yeah,
he should be able to. If he is still the parent, he should. And it's not. It hasn't been like legally.
I don't know that it's legally like criminal yet until a court says no. You have to have visitations. Then at that point.
Well, are they divorced? What is absconded?
It doesn't sound like it's official yet.
Right.
It's filing for separation.
Oh yeah, then he can still see his kid.
Yes, the answer to that question is consult your attorney, SpaceJack 2084. That is the proper answer to the question. That's why they make shitload of money.
Yep. I had to come over here for some reason.
Lono Archon, Rich and Jack, you guys are given a certificate to eat at any restaurant that you want and can bring anyone with you. Where would you go eat?
It'd have to be a fucking expensive fucking restaurant.
I'm a simple man. I just want to go to El Fuego. Get their fucking chimichangas. Look, a whole gang can come with.
I mean, El Fuego's great. El Fuego's a fine Mexican restaurant.
There's no expensive food that I want.
One, there are better Mexican restaurants in the area. El Fuego...
El Fuego's fucking great, Jack.
It's fine.
It's fucking great.
You have maybe have
it's
not.
It's really fucking good.
Maybe you've never had like good Mexican food. El Fuego is fine. But you know, you could go to Moe's downtown and have one of their like 25-year aged steak tenderloin pieces that will melt like butter. Like you get it cooked just rare enough, and your knife. You just place your knife on it, and it'll melt like butter. It's steak that will kill you. It's so good.
Does anyone you hate own a restaurant?
Anyone I hate?
Yeah.
Not that I know of. Oh, maybe. Why? Actually, now that I think about it.
A certificate to eat at any restaurant. So I'm assuming, you know, we don't have to pay, and you can bring anyone.
Right.
We pick a person who we hate. We go to their restaurant. Most expensive thing on the menu, and we invite everybody in the chat.
Oh, now we're talking. I'm on it. I'm on the trolley now. I like it. I'm down. I do know someone who owns a restaurant that I don't like. That lift lock needs to open before this. Y'all can make it through them double lasers if your mount shield can protect your face and boost. That lift lock needs to open before this gravel lift will go much of anywhere. Rich has learned too much from that revenge video. Revenge is always on my mind. Always. I've not seen The Killing Joke yet. Is it available online? I assume. I don't know if it's available to rent online. I wouldn't see it unless it was available to rent. Wait, what? Am I just missing something?
Everyone tells me it's fucking terrible.
That's all I've heard. All I've heard is terrible, terrible things.
Does Mark Hamill do a good job in the scenes he has to do a good job in?
Okay. Y'all can make it through those double lasers. Yeah, I did that. That lift lock needs to open before this gravel lift will go much of y'all can make it through them double lasers if your mount shield can protect your face. But I did that.
Look, I'd like not to pirate it. That lift lock needs to open y'all.
Oh, caboose is what he's saying. Sorry, it sounded like he was saying you can make it through there if you boost, but he was saying caboose. Very different.
Seven of Borgnine says, Rich and Jack.
Ah, yes.
I just watched Day of the Dead for the first time, and it was great and quite gory. What was the last movie that disturbed you, either viscerally or mentally?
Oof. That's a tall order.
Well, I know there's been something that's disturbed me since Day of the Dead. I can't... My brain's not working. I have been disturbed by movies before. Actually, way back in the day, when I was a kid, just plain old Night of the Living Dead freaked me out. No, I'm dead serious. That's not a joke. That movie scared the shit out of me. The concept scared the shit out of me.
Really?
Yes.
Interesting.
Nowhere to fucking run, Jack. You're left with boarding yourself in a house, which is siege warfare. And eventually, either you're going to starve to death, or those zombies, and those, like, creepy walking corpses.
Yeah.
Most disturbing thing in the world to me. They are... George Romero zombies are, like, the perfect embodiment of death. And eventually, they're going to break down your door, and they're going to slowly eat you alive. It's horrible. And you can't run, because they're everywhere. You are fucked. In a George Romero zombie movie.
That's true. That's absolutely true, Rich.
No, they're the perfect embodiment of death, the Romero zombie.
Yeah, they're great.
They're inevitable. They're everywhere. You can't run from them. You can delay them for a time, but eventually they will get you, and you will be one of them. You will be dead. It's perfect.
It's perfect. I agree.
Favorite of the Romero trilogy. Well, are you counting the remake? Because he did that too. Didn't he also do the remake, Romero, or did he have somebody else direct it for him?
With what?
Night of the Living Dead. There was a remake in the 80s.
Oh, yeah, I think he did that one.
I remember that not being bad. I'd have to rewatch that. Dawn is really fucking good, though.
Dawn's great. Dawn's the one.
Tom Savini directed the remake. Okay.
Oh, did he? Oh, okay. That makes sense.
91. Okay. Yeah, after my exposure to those zombie movies when I was a kid, I want to say months to a year, I couldn't go to bed without making sure not only that my door was locked, but that all the doors in the house were locked, and also the windows.
That's powerful.
Intellectually, I knew it was just a movie, but emotionally, I couldn't deal with it.
Sure. That's crazy. Bloop. Bloop.
I have no interest in streaming Vampires, The Masquerade, anything. Bunch of whiny emo shit.
Sounds great. Looks like y'all found a listening
station. I'll tell you all about it. Got the emo too serious crap.
Sounds like a great game.
Fuck Anne Rice and everything she stands for.
Remember, you know, she was like zombie porn, and now she's a Christian author. Like, her first books were like...
Is that true?
And then the two zombie dudes who had totally six-packs just hugged each other and made out for a little bit. Yeah, now she's like a conservative Christian author. And now the sexy vampires, they took the lady unwillingly. Yeah, she's crazy. That Ayn Rand? Oh, she's crazy.
She's not Christian-y anymore.
Oh, is she not? She was for a while, though. I'm a member of that. I'm a member when she was all Christian-y. Hello, Head.
When I was younger, I thought I liked vampires because I was really fond of the movie Near Dark.
Okay.
That was a great take on vampires. It wasn't until I got older and I realized that the popular vision of vampires, that kind of gothy nonsense, that I completely lost interest.
That's fair.
You ever watch Near Dark?
Near Dark, no.
That's great. That's great. He gets bitten. They make him a vampire, but they're kind of like a... They're not really like romantic vampires. They're just kind of like drifters, almost nomads.
Uh-huh.
And he doesn't want to kill people.
I've heard of this. I've heard of Near Dark.
The others, you know, they've been doing it so long, they don't give a shit anymore. But he doesn't want to kill someone. Near Dark is great.
Oh, okay. I've heard of this before, I think.
The ending is terrible. But everything until you get... He's cured by a blood transfusion. I'll fucking spoil it because it's so stupid. It's so goddamn stupid, I'm going to spoil it.
Wow.
Yeah. Are the Lost Boys emo? No, I would lump that in like the same... That's the same... I watched that around the time I saw Near Dark for the first time. That's when I thought I liked vampires. Oh, Lost Boys is great. Near Dark is great. Vampires are cool. Interview with a Vampire. Fright Night. Was
Fright
great.
Night, yeah.
You had Fright Night and Lost Boys and Near Dark.
And then Anne Rice
And then it all...
Anne
Rice came
in
and it all went to fucking hell.
And then... Oh, and then the boys, they looked, and they were handsome. The boys were so handsome.
Orange access accepted. Sorry, Jen says, I kind of want to play Necropolis with Jack again.
I'm okay with that.
How close were you to winning the whole fucking game? You've been playing that for ages.
We made it really far. We made it very far. I have no idea how close we were, but we made it a good long way. I feel like we made it a good long way.
Does Rich mean Stephanie Meyer? No, she didn't help.
Which one was she?
The Twilight.
She didn't help.
Hump J. Bear says... The bug scene in Peter Jackson's King Kong is quite disturbing. The hopelessness as they get overwhelmed and the lack of sound freak me out in the cinema. You know what's going to happen? It's going to be tomorrow afternoon, and I'm going to think of something in a movie that really disturbed me. And I'm like, oh, God damn it, why didn't I think of that then? It's going to happen.
Yeah, and it's just how, you know, you see so many. It's hard for me to put my finger on any one particular thing that really disturbed me. I'm sure there was a ton of stuff at the time.
Jack, what font are we using for the stream graphics?
Probably Helvetica New. Helvetica New in the black configuration, which is very thick, chunky. But that's just a font that I use often because it's clean and easy to read, but I have no idea if that's actually the font we are using. G-hole. I'll let you know that.
Take it easy in there. It can get a bit hairy.
And it's just a font I use. I know you guys complain about the font, and so, like, originally I was using a different font. I got a new one, because you guys didn't like that one. Is So that's my story about the phone.
Sync scene from the Blob remake. I don't specifically remember that particular scene. Though the Blob is another horrifying concept.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Blob was great.
If y'all want to power this old boy down, y'all gonna have to yank out that crystal nose. But I don't need to tell y'all.
Maybe I should rephrase the question, says Young Bubbles. Young Bubbies. Since you guys are hack frauds, how much of a tip do you require to stream Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines? I'm not interested in the game. It's not an extortion thing. I'm simply not interested. I've never been much of a role-playing game guy, and I typically find vampires obnoxious.
I think that's fair. Oh, fuck. I think it's fair, Rich. Putting it out there.
Would you do it for 1,000? I would do it for 2,000. Because I have to split that shit with Jack.
Just tell him no, Rich. That's fine. What if I don't want to do it either?
I'm going to pull a Hillary Clinton, and then once they donate the 2,000, I'm going to weasel out of it. That's my plan.
Don't make me start talking about Ghostbusters.
At this time, it is not right to play Vampire the Masquerade.
What?
Oh. Some of the crystal nodes are still connected to the power generator.
Crazy, Rich. You're bringing up. You're being crazy town.
I'll say one more thing, but we're not going to discuss it.
Oh God.
We're not going to discuss this. I'm just going to bring this up. Cat in the Pick is saying, the official Ghostbusters Twitter account.
Oh no.
Just endorsed Hillary Clinton because that situation wasn't unnecessarily political enough already.
You know what? That's fair.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah.
I guess. Here's the thing. Is anyone surprised by this? No. Did they need to do that? No. You know, that's just one of those things where it's like, if the individual actresses, producers, directors wanted to do that, like, that's where you do it. If I make any, like, I made a political joke this morning on Twitter. And you know what? I did it on my Twitter account. I wouldn't do it on previously recorded Twitter account, you know? I try not to bring that shit in here. But if, like, the actresses want to do it, they... So wait, what do I gotta do? But yeah, that's funny. I agree, that's funny.
So how is the game?
Eh.
Yeah, that's how I felt when I was playing, which is why I kind of threw the controller to you and didn't really look back. Do you want to switch for a while? Are you bored enough?
I mean, I'm bored, but I can do it and talk and.
Are you bored enough to want to just put something else
on? Eh, we'll see what we can do.
All right.
You know what? Like, this is a game that I can play and talk at the same time.
Okay.
If you want to play and talk at the same time, you seem to have a little.
I don't want to be unfair to you, is what I'm saying.
Oh no, it's fine. Everything's fine. Where do I go? What do I do?
And that's sad when you're offering to play the game to be nice. Well, you don't have to play this game.
Both of us. It's fine. If I want, I guess. It's...
You can play it. No, you can play it.
No, please. You play it. You know.
Please.
Jesus Christ. You need to play this. I can't. Yeah, I mean, it's just not... It's There's nothing terribly engaging about the game.
This game is actually clever and funny if you were paying attention.
I'm
not shocked because Tim Schafer is clever and funny.
Yeah.
Once again, once you divorce story from the game, what you got? A story you can make up for a lot. Maybe it does in this case.
It could. You know, I don't care how adorable the story is, though. This is kind of boring.
Yeah, playing it without paying attention to the story, I was kind of like, eh. Yeah, but I don't doubt there's a lot of clever shit going on.
Oh, sure.
Because Tim Schafer is good at that.
Uh-huh.
I know everyone hates him now because politics. But... Man did Brutal Legend, which I like. I think it's flawed. I think it's not finished. I think there's a third of Brutal Legend that needs to be made or never was made.
Yeah. I never played Brutal Legend because, you know, it's a real-time strategy game.
It's missing a third act.
Oh. Yeah.
And, I mean, not just story-wise, but I mean, like, a large chunk of the game is tutorial, and then by the time you start actually using the mechanics, it's over.
Oh.
It's a single-player experience? Yeah.
Oop, wrong way.
What else was I going to say? Oh, he also made Grim Fandango, too. Which...
Oh, yeah. Fine.
Clever, funny.
Yeah, you know what? Even... whatchamacallit that we played for the thing? I forgot the name of it. The Double Fine Adventure game. Whatever the fuck it's called. It was cute. You know, I didn't like it, but it was cute. What is that game called?
Which one?
The Double Fine Adventure game.
Oh, God.
Right.
Oh, my God.
Don't look at the
I'm
chat.
I'm not looking at the chat. I'm not looking at the chat. Oh, my God!
Between...
Gone Home? No, it wasn't Gone Home. That was something else.
Two Worlds? It was Two Worlds. Don't look at the chat. Don't look at the chat. What
I don't think
that
was... Broken Age!
Bo! Rich! Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ! That, and by the way, that tells you exactly how memorable that game was. Fuck, man.
Look, it was what it said it was gonna be. I can't fault it for that.
Broken Age. I'm still waiting. Very soon I'm gonna get the, because I was a backer for that. Very soon I'm going to get the DVD of all the behind-the-scenes stuff, which was worth... Like, I got to watch most of it already anyway, but that was worth backing it along.
Mm-hmm.
The story of them making that game was way better than the game.
Kind of like Gorilla Interrupted. Well, that DVD is worth it for the making of...
You know?
I'd feel bad if we just sold the movie. Gorilla Interrupted.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Anonymous says, will you guys be at PonyCon New York City next year? No. Unequivocally, no. Is that the right word? Definitely no.
Fuck no. You guys are silly. Y'all a bunch of sillies. This one's got more crystal nodes with the remote.
What happened during the making? Gorilla Interrupted! For anybody who doesn't know. A few years ago, we re-released it. We sold the DVD of the movie. We made that when we were, like, college age. Uh-huh. Well before RLM was a thing. It was one of the first things that me, Mike, and Jay kind of collaborated on. And basically it was a feature-length film that we made in literally a week.
Mm-hmm.
And, obviously the end result is terrible because we made it in a week. But when we released the DVD of it, we also made a huge documentary called How Not to Make a Movie.
Yes.
And I think that's interesting stuff. But
yeah, that's a fun watch. That's a fun watch, How Not to Make a Movie. I've gotten myself trapped.
That lift lock needs to open before this gravel lift will go much of anywhere.
Whoa! Shit.
We have not had a vote on the layout.
No, because everyone seems to be cool with it now.
Oh no!
Haven't heard a lot of talkings about it. haven't heard a word. If we're gonna do a vote on it, there's got to be three options, right?
Uh huh.
Like it, hate it, or it doesn't matter either way. That's my
okay.
Right?
Okay.
Because I have a feeling that a large majority of the people are really just gonna say, I don't really care.
What about needs work? You can put a fourth one in there.
Ooh,
needs
my
work.
Lord.
Seven of Borgnine says, Rich, you were right and Jay was wrong about Max having a change of heart in Road Warrior. He only goes back to town because he had no choice. He is a badass, but is not an altruistic person. Yes. Fully agree. Road Warrior is not about redemption. They're not there yet. You don't get that until Fury Road. I mean, and well, Beyond Thunderdome.
Mm.
If you hate Beyond Thunderdome, they also kind of did it in Fury Road. So you just replace that movie. And then you have a whole character arc for Max.
That lift lock needs to open before this gravel lift will go much of anywhere.
Please report to the nearest conformity enforcement for the mandatory post-work sample to
fuck. They're putting a straw pole up here.
What?
It's the straw pole going on.
Let him put it up. Let him put it up.
Okay. Just letting you know what's happening.
Let him do it. Let him do what they're going to do, Rich. You let them do what they're going to do. They're going to put it up. They're going to put it up.
Some of the crystal nodes are still connected to the power generator.
You guys have favorite film scores. Favorite game scores. Do you have any favorite film scores? It's not necessarily memorable on its own, but it's highly effective as a score. The Ghostbusters score, not the theme song, the score, the Elmer Bernstein score, does not get anywhere near enough love.
Hmm. Interesting. Yeah, a little bubbly, a little fun. Yeah.
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 It evokes a classic comedy without, while still being a little bit... A little bit creepy, but not really creepy in places.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ghostbusters' score doesn't draw attention to itself. It's just perfect for the film.
Hmm. I can be with you.
Anything by John Carpenter. The man knows how to do an effective score. Jack, do you have any thoughts on that? Film scores?
No.
No? That's
I'm
fine.
Sorry.
And that's fine. That's fine. You don't have to.
Good. Good. I'm just going to say like Jurassic Park, you know, where it's like that's an easy one. But nothing that I can really think of.
Yellow access granted. The
citizens' robotic bodies may not tire after a 96 Would RLM hours. Continue, Rich, if either you or Mike retired? I think you could throw Jay in there, too. Jack, we'll go on without Jack. I think that's safe to say.
It does go on without me.
Pre-wreck would not.
No. Listen, I'm here like a quarter of the time.
I think it would go on without me.
I don't know about that.
It would go on.
Yeah, it would limp on.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm not sure how well we do without Mike or Jay, though. Basically, we're the expendable ones.
Mm-hmm. I'm the expendable one. Like I said, without you, it would limp on. I don't know how far they'd make it without you.
Yes, I am the mascot. And that's why it would be able to go on without me. Without RLM, Rich would be a worse experience. Thank you.
Wait, what?
They said it backwards. Without Rich, you know, you'd think it would be like, without Rich, RLM would be a lesser experience.
Yeah.
They turned it around.
Yeah.
Rich is a funnier character than we've had before. I've never heard that one. Oh my god, that's new material. We got new things coming out of the chat. They're clever, creativity. I'm always amazed by the creativity of our fan base. Jesus Christ, our comment sections are so depressing.
Rich, careful, you're gonna pull a muscle with all this sarcasm.
Boy, we go out of our way to put out, you know, clever original shit, and then the comment section just repeat things we said 5 years ago. It's great! It's great, I love it. It's good to show contempt for your audience. I still love you guys. But seriously, you gotta get new material. And now what's going on in the chat is really predictable. Which, the same memes over and over again.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah.
I want juicy shack meat.
There it is.
Yep.
I'm surprised that one stuck around.
Yeah.
Not saying anything negative about it, just surprised.
We're usually surprised by what sticks. Like, I don't think anyone expected what's wrong with your face to catch on.
Right. Yeah, that's an interesting one.
There's usually some line that we didn't think would hit big that is, like, repeated.
Well, I think that's what surprised me most about Juicy Shack Meat, where it's like, that was, you got, you know, Mike was trying to do something.
Like, I thought Plape was the funniest fucking thing in the world.
Plape?
From a Best of the Worst episode where this post-apocalyptic gang, they capture this girl and they tie her up.
Yeah.
And they read Shakespeare to her. They force her to read Shakespeare. And I said, oh no, she's been plaped.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Everyone in the room, I guess you weren't there that episode. Everyone in the room thought it was the funniest fucking thing in the world, including me. And I said it. And that's really kind of pathetic. And it never really been quoted. Never really been quoted. It was in the episode. And, you know, mild reaction.
You hear that, everyone? You want to make Rich's day? Make Plape happen.
Yeah, it's fine. I forgot what the movie was, but somebody said something that sounded like Dr. Mayonnaise. Like, the character's, like, his name was Dr. Mayonnaise.
Yeah.
I thought that was hysterical. I dropped a hint that somebody should change their username to Dr. Mayonnaise. And, you know, when the episode came out, nobody cared about that line. Nobody fucking cared about that line. So it's, a lot of the times, it's not the lines we think are going to land that land.
That's true. You're speaking truth, Rich.
Yellow doesn't make you a special fellow.
Yes, I'm fond of Skost myself, says the chat. Skost was fine. What do we got here?
I don't know, Rich. I'm losing it.
You don't. You, whenever you're done, you can be done.
Okay.
Jorglin says, "Hey, Rich, just finished watching Stranger Things.
Hey.
Just a quick tip to thank you and Jay for pushing me into it. I probably would have not seen it without a glowing recommendation from you guys. You're welcome. Glad you enjoyed it.
Fuck yeah."
Anonymous says, "Rich.
Rich.
You are to RLM what the Fonzie is to Happy Days."
Oh, that's true.
Fonzie's way too cool.
I think you see yourself as a mascot, but you're a spirit animal.
I am more like what Kramer was to Seinfeld. I think that's an honest assessment.
I don't know about that. Potato, potato. Fonzie and Kramer. Potato, potato, Rich. That's what I'm saying. I'm so fucking done with this game.
Okay. We're done with this game.
Okay, great. I'm bored. I'm bored. I'm bored! You had to... There were lifts and you had to find locks or whatever. I'm done.
Okay. That's fine by me.
Jack is Poochie. Yeah, probably Poochie. Yeah, probably calling it a night. Probably calling it a night. Sari Chan, I don't have any room for Steam friends. I'm sorry. But if I make some room, I will look for your name. When I make some room, I just need more cards. I'll go through and call my friend list like you did.
About which?
Calling my Steam friend list. Like, oh. You know, I'll go see who hasn't been on in like, you know, a year.
Yeah.
Start making some cuts. Yeah.
I did that. And apparently one of the ones I called wasn't one that had abandoned Steam.
Oh.
Sometimes they have like no information. I just assume that meant they hadn't been on for a really long time.
Sure.
That might just be, I guess, when you have like information blocked or something. I don't know. But I called somebody and like 10 minutes later I got a chat thing. Why did you drop me as a friend? I'm like, oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know. I've been just calling people.
Beefcake says, according to the straw poll, it's Mad Don't Care.
Mad Don't Care?
Mad Don't Care.
Okay.
Great. That's what I figured it would be. This is only something that I felt strongly about. And they say, I don't care. Great. Great. Rich had me on Facebook.
Nope. People have tried. And I'm not being rude, but yeah. Facebook, I strictly used to keep in touch with family and closer friends.
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. You gotta have your cutoffs.
Like I used to, you know, like people I went to high school with. Yeah, I kind of knew them in high school. I even stopped doing that because I just don't give a fuck what they're doing. It's like, God, I'm sick of seeing posts from this jerk I haven't talked to in 20 years. I don't give a shit what they're doing.
I don't. Yeah, that's the real thing. It's like, if I cared about you, I'd still be hanging out with you. Like,
yeah.
I still see people from high school, but like those are my friends.
That's why I don't give a shit about my high school reunion. Yeah, anybody in high school, if you're in high school, and I'm assuming most of our users aren't. I'm not even sure what the demographics are anymore. It's fine, but
I think they're all older. I think they're like us.
The people you're really truly good friends with, you're gonna keep in touch with them.
Oh yeah, you don't need no Facebooks, no Snapchats. You don't need no nothing. What?
Like if I accepted everyone as my Facebook friend, like a post by my dad that I might want to read will get buried under 490 other people's posts.
People move up layer.
If I let everybody in, that would be madness. Madness.
I will look into that, Meeble. Thank you.
Alright. So you want to start reading names? What's going on?
Oh, sure. What?
Oh, are you looking for some?
Oh, they're giving me our pre-rec logo looks a little... I'm pointing to it, but you see the thing. Never mind. Our pre-rec logo looks a little jaggedy, and I tried to fix that. But it's just the way that the stroke works in Photoshop, and so they were giving me some hints to get rid of the jaggedy edges.
Oh, okay.
But, yeah, I mean, it's mostly fine. Sure, let's see what we have here. We have Space Allen Super Cocaine, who says, is this the Highlander in space?
No.
No.
No, this is not. Oh, because their heads are getting removed. I get it.
Oh, I didn't get that.
Yeah, yeah.
I get it. So, yeah, you know what? Yes, it is.
Pizza Train 11. 18 months in a row.
The off switch.
X Mensa. 25 months in a row.
Ooh.
And I'm assuming they subbed earlier in the stream because it's near the top of the list.
Yeah.
Yet, we only just recently talked about Fonzie, right?
Yeah.
This comment is, "Ey!" Nice. Some psychic shit going on there. X Mensa. Nice. Or X Mensa really is X Mensa. He left Mensa because he was too smart for Mensa. And he knew we were going to be talking about Happy Days.
Yeah.
He or she, I guess. Whatever.
Loner Archon, 23 fucking months in a row. And Loner Archon says, look up Space Base DF9 and see why we distrust Double Fine.
I get it. I know.
No, and you know what? This was an acceptable game. I just didn't think it was like, eh. That's all it was. I know they had some space base. We know about the drama of space base.
I know about the drama of space base. I also know a lot of the hates he gets is because of some kind of SJW thing.
Is it?
I think so.
Jesus Christ.
That label's been through. And I don't even want to get into shit like that.
Nope, we're not getting into it.
Yeah.
Not getting into it.
He's funny. I still think he's funny.
In this one, we flew a rocket ship that looked like a wiener in balls. That was great.
Well, there might be clever dialogue and shit that we didn't hear because we weren't paying any attention to that, to be fair.
None of them. But we had a wiener
in balls. We were being kind of bored by the game, though. Yeah. I think that's also fair.
Yeah.
Swedish AI.
Lando was taken 22 fucking months in a row.
Misner won 19 months in a row. I can't think of anything to put here, so I'll just leave it blank.
That's probably fair.
Six.
For 26. Six. Fucking months in a row.
Satanist. A Michelle 87. 23 fucking months in a row. She says 23 months goes by so fast.
So fast. The Great Escape Artist. Welcome.
Haplogorath. That's an interesting name. Haplogorath.
I like it. Maybe it's Haplog-O-Wrath. Like a log that's hateful. A log of wrath. A log of wrath.
Sure,
and their first name is Hap. Drummer Film Guy. Welcome.
The Ox from Arizona. And welcome to YouTube.
Veggie64, who says, I open the stream and first thing I hear is about dick sucking. This is why I subscribe.
And a reminder, watch your Stranger Things. Because that's, bizarrely, that's what inspired that.
Oh, yeah. Listen, next Wednesday is the Stranger Things super spoiler discussion. So watch it by next Wednesday. You have been warned.
I'm very curious if anybody who watches our streams is not an 80s kid. If you're older, if you're a younger person, I'm very curious what you would have to say about Stranger Things. Once you take the nostalgia factor out of Stranger Things,
like if you are,
what is the reaction?
If you are a 20-something, what is your reaction to Stranger Things?
Very curious about that. Where are we at?
I don't know. Where are we? Beyond Infinite?
Yeah, okay. Beyond Infinite! I just got on, and yes, Jack referred to oral sex.
Yay! Yep, I'm glad you guys like that.
Are they seeing those comments?
No.
How do they...
Oh, yeah. These show up in chat.
They show up in the chat? Okay, okay.
Yeah. Smiling Strange, 23 fucking months in a row. Thank you.
Visceral Attacks on Stairs.
Nice. Heritatsu, or just Heritatsu, 18 months in a row.
Professor Physics, 20 fucking months in a row. And Professor Physics says, fuck me, baby.
Oh, Jesus. You put some effort into that.
Word fuck just lends itself to effort.
Hunchback Jack, 14 months in a row. And Hunchback Jack says, it's 98 in dog months.
Usury Name, 21 fucking months in a row.
Cesarian Fart. 15 months in a row.
And Jolly Nihilist, thank you for subscribing. We really appreciate it.
It's true. We really do. Thank you, everybody. Thanks for coming out. You know, even though we might have been a little tired, we got some Stranger Things. And more importantly...